All right, Savannah Guthrie at the White House for us tonight. Thanks. An increasingly bitter dispute has been playing out in recent weeks between Congressman Patrick Kennedy, the youngest son of the late Ted Kennedy, and his Roman Catholic bishop. As NBC's Ron Allen reports tonight, it is the latest instance of the church asserting a role in some of this nation's most contentious issues.
As the nation grapples with emotional issues like health care reform, abortion, and same-sex marriage, the Catholic Church is flexing its religious and political muscle.
All health insurance plans.
Caught up in an unlikely personal argument with Representative Patrick Kennedy, son of the late senator, over his bishop's request in a confidential letter not to take communion because he supports abortion rights.
Keep in mind, I didn't go after him. He started this dialogue when he attacked the church now nearly a month ago. To receive a sacrament, you have to be in union with the church.
Last month, Kennedy had publicly chastised the church for demanding tough abortion restrictions in the health care reform bill. Today, he could not be reached for comment, but recently spoke to Cybercast News Service.
If the church is pro-life, then they ought to be for health care reform because it's going to provide health care that are going to keep people alive.
Critics say the Catholic Church, which like all religious institutions is tax-exempt and not-for-profit, has rarely been this aggressive politically.
I think the church sees this as a golden opportunity to turn church doctrine into the law of the United States at every level. And frankly, they're not above using spiritual and political blackmail to do it.
In Washington, D.C., where the city council could approve a same-sex marriage bill next week, church leaders warned the law would force them to end decades of programs it runs with the city, helping the needy. That's because the law would require groups like Catholic Charities, which accept public funding, to provide full employee benefits to same-sex couples, something the church refuses to do. Church leaders say they are morally obligated to take strong stands on policy issues.
We have the right and the duty, I think, to bring a spiritual vision and spiritual values into these discussions.
Equal rights!
Discussions over heated issues that divide a prominent congressman and his church and Americans of all faiths. Ron Allen, NBC News, New York.